In this lecture, I will solve one numerical problem based on diode rectifier circuits. We have full wave bridge rectifier given in the problem. We have full wave bridge rectifier given in the problem, and we need to calculate DC output voltage. DC output voltage is also called as average output voltage. In the B part, we need to calculate the rectification efficiency. We need to calculate the efficiency of the full wave bridge rectifier. In the C part, we need to calculate peak inverse voltage, PIV. And in the last part, we need to calculate the output frequency. Let's say the output frequency is FO. So these are the four parameters that we need to calculate for the given full wave bridge rectifier. You can see the input frequency is equal to 50 Hz and the turns ratio is equal to 10:1. The input frequency F in is equal to 50 Hz and the turns ratio NP by NS is equal to 10/1. I'm interested in calculating input voltage VI, and we already know NP by NS is equal to VP by VS, voltage on the primary side and voltage on the secondary side. Voltage on the primary side is equal to 220 volts, so this is equal to 220 volts divided by VS. This implies voltage on the secondary side is equal to 220 volts divided by 10, so VS or input voltage is equal to 22 volts. Now we will calculate the DC output voltage. I will solve the A part of the problem. We will calculate the DC output voltage. The DC output voltage V average or VDC is equal to twice of VM divided by pi. This is the formula for the DC output voltage. We need to calculate VM in order to calculate the DC output voltage. VM is the peak or maximum value of input voltage. We know VRMS is equal to VM divided by root 2, and VRMS is equal to VI. So VM divided by root 2 is equal to 22 volts. So VM is equal to 22 volts multiplied by root 2. When you solve this, you will have VM equal to 31.11 volts. Now we can easily calculate the DC voltage. V average is equal to 2 multiplied by 31.11 divided by 3.14. Pi is equal to 3.14. When you solve this, you will have 19.81 volts as the value of average voltage or DC voltage. This is the answer of the A part. Now we will solve the B part. In B part, we need to calculate the rectification efficiency. We already know efficiency is equal to the output power divided by the input power. Output power is equal to I DC square multiplied by R, and input power is equal to I RMS square multiplied by R. In terms of voltage, we have V DC square divided by R divided by V RMS square divided by R. This R and this R will cancel out. So finally, we have V DC square divided by V RMS square. Generally, we calculate efficiency in terms of percentage. So percentage efficiency is equal to VDC square divided by VRMS square multiplied by 100. VDC square, we have already calculated, is equal to 19.81, and VRMS is equal to 22 volts. This is the value of VRMS. So we can easily calculate the percentage efficiency, 19.81 square divided by 22 square multiplied by 100, and when you solve this, you will have 81.08% as the value of efficiency. So this is the answer of the P part. Now we will calculate the C part. In the C part, we have to find out peak inverse voltage, and we already know peak inverse voltage for the full wave bridge rectifier must be greater than or equal to VM, the maximum value of input voltage. And in case of full wave center tap rectifier, peak inverse voltage must be greater than or equal to twice of VM. Vm is equal to 31.11. So peak inverse voltage must be greater than or equal to 31.11 volts. This is the answer for the C part. Now we will calculate the last part, the D part, and this is important part because I have not covered it in the earlier lectures. So let's see how to calculate the output frequency for full wave rectifier. For this, first I will draw the input and output waveforms. The input waveform is like this. This is Vi, and the output waveform, the rectified waveform, is like this. And we already know frequency is equal to 1 by t, and time period in this case is, let's say, equal to t, and time period in this case is, let's say, equal to t prime. If we compare t and t prime, we can see t prime is equal to half of t. So t is equal to twice of t prime, and from here we can see time period is equal to 1 by f, and let's say frequency is equal to f in for this waveform, for the input waveform, and frequency is fo for this waveform. So t is equal to 1 by f in equal to 2 time 1 by fo. So I can write fo, the output frequency, is 2 times input frequency, and input frequency is equal to 50 hertz. So output frequency is equal to 2 multiplied by 50 hertz, and this is equal to 100 hertz. This is the answer of the D part. The output frequency is equal to 2 times the input frequency in case of full wave rectifiers. This is very important point. You may note it down somewhere if you want to. I will end this lecture here. If you have any doubt, you may ask in the comment section.